Councilors-elect Buzzy Barton and Hong Net escort the school committee members-elect to their places on stage to receive their oath of office. Will Councilors-elect Darren Sear and William Trahant please notify the mayor that the school committee-elect and the city council-elect are ready to be sworn in. Lynn Fire Chief Carmody and Police Chief Coppinger will escort Piranha the mayor. English High School Marine Corps Junior ROTC will now make a presentation of colors. Can we all please rise? The Star Spangled Banner, which will be performed by the Lynn Public Schools Jazz Band.
Aye.
Thank you. also like to recognize our State Senator Tom McGee, who's with us this evening, State Representative Bob Fennell, and State Representative Stephen Walsh. I'd now like to invite to the stage the Aspara Cambodian Dance Troupe, who will perform for us this evening.
Thank you.
right to the podium for the invocation, Reverend Brian Flynn, pastor of St. Mary's.
Let us pray. God of justice and mercy, thank you for the many gifts that you have bestowed upon us. And thank you for the opportunity to serve the people of our city. Send your blessing upon all of those here this evening. Help us to act with character and conviction. Help us to listen with understanding and goodwill. Help us to speak with charity and restraint. Always give us a spirit of service. Remind us that we are stewards of your authority, and guide us to be the leaders that your people need. Help us to see the humanity and dignity of those who disagree with us, and to treat all persons, no matter how weak or poor, with the reverence your creation deserves. And finally, Father, renew us with the strength of your presence and the joy of helping to build a community worthy of the human person. We ask this as your sons and daughters, confident in your goodness, your mercy, and your love. Amen.
America the Beautiful will now be performed by Mary Beth Mays.
Discharge and perform
all the duties incumbent on me
city of Lynn. So help me God.
So help me God.
I take your name.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will uphold and affirm.
And defend the Constitution.
Of the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. So help me God.
So help me God.
James Lamont, Associate Justice of District Court, the Lynn Division, to please administer the oath of office to the school committee elect. As the people on this stage are literally right now beginning their term, I'd like a special recognition for Councilor Richard Colucci, who as of right now is the longest serving city councilor in the city of Lynn's history. It is my honor to invite to the podium for mayoral remarks, Her Honor, Mayor Judith Flanagan Kennedy.
Delegation, Senator McGee, clergy, honored guests, friends, family, and to you, my fellow citizens of Lynn. 2 years ago tonight, when I first addressed the citizens of Lynn as your mayor, I noted that our city had come to a fork in the road, and that we could choose either the familiar sights and clearly marked path of the status quo, or the unmarked and often rocky road toward a new destiny. It appeared to me that the results of that election in 2009 indicated that the city was eager to set out into uncharted terrain. Due to the short time allotted for my remarks tonight, I would like to focus on two of the features of the new path that the city of Lynn has chosen. Inclusion of all Lynners in the process of government and bringing the government to the people by such means as televised school committee and city council meetings, easy to read online budget information, and user-friendly municipal websites that provide near-instant access to the workings of your elected officials. As to the first point, the proof that many of you have heeded the call for inclusion in your government is apparent on this stage tonight. Joining Maria Carrasco, a three-term member of the school committee, are Buzzy Barton and Hong Nen. Counselor-at-Large Barton is the first person of color to serve on the city council since 1997. And Counselor-at-Large Nen is the first Asian American ever to hold elective office. The city has started to demarcate and pave that road for a government, in the words of Councillor Nett's campaign slogan, will be for all voices. The second feature of this new path that I have chosen to highlight tonight is to create a connection between the people and the government. We have made great strides in the past 2 years in providing unprecedented access to information to the people of Lynn via the internet, cable television, and multilingual translations of important city ordinances. However, many of those ordinances themselves are obsolete, piecemeal, or simply not enforced. For example, if you visit the city clerk's link on the city's website, you will find the following ordinances still in effect. In section 2.24.010, regarding the city's police department, and last updated decades ago, we are required to have 2 police women as sworn officers, as well as 30 reserve police officers. The city currently has 13 sworn female police officers and no reserve officers. Again, according to the ordinance, section 2.24.010, which covers the city's fire department, the city must have 9 district fire chiefs and 1 mechanic. We currently have 5 district fire chiefs per the existing collective bargaining agreement and have not had a mechanic on the fire department payroll since the 1990s. Section 2.76.080, which sets out the wages of various city workers, lists the pay scale that was in effect as of July of 1972. Section 2.76.070 still contains provisions for seamstresses and institutional cooks, positions that have been obsolete for over a decade. And the list goes on and on. I believe that anyone wishing to peruse the city's ordinances should be able to go to the city clerk's website or visit her office and get a firm idea of how this city will function in 2012 and beyond. Our city ordinances should be relevant to today and should reflect what our government is comprised of, how our city departments are structured, and what citizens of Lynn can and cannot do within the city's boundaries. I challenge this new city council to take a hard look at the existing city ordinances in the next 2 years and update this compilation to reflect how our government functions in the 21st century. In a similar vein, I propose that the current city charter be considered for a complete overhaul. The charter has not been completely revised since 1978, more than 3 decades ago. The world has changed greatly since that time, as has the city. Some examples of the provisions that should be entirely revised or eliminated include any references to a director of data processing as a position in our city, as the rest of the world has long since progressed to an age of information technology. The inclusion of the language of the Bailout Act of 1985. At the time that this language was included in the charter, Lynn was on the verge of bankruptcy. Although at that time such drastic fiscal restraints were necessary, Lynn is now on a solid, if not prosperous, financial footing. I believe that it is time to revisit language that is a quarter of a century old to determine its continuing relevance. The provision containing concerning mayoral succession in the event that a mayor cannot fulfill his or her elected term. Although the City of Lynn instituted a four-year term for mayor beginning in 2002, we never changed Chapter 2, Section 2.9 of the City Charter to reflect this change. And as a result, the City Charter addresses only the first 15 months and the last 9 months of a mayor's term of office. No provisions are included for the intermediate 2 years of a mayor's term. We have begun to forge that road to a new and modern Lynn. I ask all of the City Council members, as well as my fellow school committee members, to support me in my efforts to continue to usher Lynn toward a future that allows all of its citizens to participate in the rebirth of our great and proud city. Thank you.
Thank you, Your Honor. I'd like to now invite to the stage for a performance the Bremer School of Irish Dance. Thank you very much. For those of you that don't know, my name is Tim Phelan. I am the current City Council President. And it's my honor once again to have the opportunity on behalf of my colleagues to provide inaugural remarks this evening. I have been reminded by many, even some colleagues earlier this evening, to keep it short, so that is my intent. Somebody reminded me that I said that last inauguration and I went on a little too long, so I hope to do my best. First, I'd like to start by taking my hat off to each and every one of you on stage, and every candidate who fell short in their efforts to represent the people of the city of Lynn, because it takes a lot. And I'd like to express my feelings in the words of Teddy Roosevelt, who said the following in 1910. "It is not the critic who counts, not the man who points out how the strong man stumbles or where the doer of deeds could have done better. The credit belongs to the man who is actually in the arena, whose face is marred by dust and sweat and blood, who strives valiantly, who errs and comes up short again and again, because there is no effort without error or shortcoming. But who knows the great enthusiasms, the great devotions, who spends himself for a worthy cause, who at his best knows in the end the triumph of high achievement, and who, at the worst, if he fails, at least he fails while daring greatly, so that his place shall never be with those cold and timid souls who neither knew victory nor defeat. For that, every one of you and every candidate that has ever put his name on a ballot should be proud. However, it is time to turn the page on this election. That battle is over. Because it's easy to sit together tonight, but it's more important that we work together tomorrow. As elected officials, we don't have the option to do nothing. Change will not come if we wait. We all need to be less interested in passing out blame as opposed to learning from and correcting our mistakes, or the city will never move forward. Much has been made of the changing face of the elected officials in Lynn, and deservedly so. We have new, dedicated, talented people sitting on this stage, and it's my honor to work with them. It is my hope we can all learn and flourish from each other for the common good. And with the changing city, anyone would be naive to think that there are not changing responsibilities. But what we also must remember are our similarities. Because what I know, whether one is young or old, black or white, rich or poor, spiritual or otherwise, from every corner of our great city of Lynn, the people really want the same thing. They want an affordable roof over their heads. They want safe neighborhoods. They want good schools for their children. And they want the knowledge that their elected officials aren't wasting their tax dollars. For those of us who have been here before as elected officials, it's not about the work we've done, but the work that we have to do in the future. We will all face an array of challenges in this new year and beyond. We will be tested, and rightfully so, because no one should run for office if they're unwilling to make a decision or unwilling to make a difficult decision. And when you do make that decision, politically correct sound bites are no substitute for sound judgment. We on this stage, together, have been entrusted by many in this city, by the people in this audience tonight, to make those decisions. And I have the confidence each of us will ensure objectivity in their roles, will ensure that no good idea is buried, nor any opinion suppressed. And if we are capable of doing that, we will most assuredly leave our city in a better position in the future than we find it today. Thank you. Invite to the stage Pierre Lynn Louise, who is going to sing God Bless America.
God bless America. Lynn, that I love.
Now I'd like to invite up for the benediction Reverend Joseph Rossi from St. Pius.
Good and gracious God, we ask your blessing this night on all the elected public officials who begin their terms now, on all those who serve, on all those who have served. We are most grateful for their willingness to assume additional responsibilities in their already busy and demanding lives. Give them the grace to seek out the lost, to heal the broken, to feed the hungry, to shelter the homeless, to advocate for the youth of this community, to free those bound unjustly, and to bring justice and peace to your people, no matter who they are. Bless them with the awareness that it is in giving that they receive, that true satisfaction and inner peace come from serving, not being served, that a firm sense of purpose comes from making the common good a priority. Give all of us an unfailing reverence and respect for our newly elected city officials, even when we disagree. May they see our heartfelt desire for pride in good leadership. Bless and protect their families and all their loved ones. Give all of us, no matter who we are, grace to be humble servants of you and of one another, in your good and gracious name. Amen.
I'd like to now invite to the stage Mizuru Kasanga Roho for a performance. Thank you. At the conclusion of tonight's event, City Council will meet in the council chambers on the fourth floor to organize for 2012. The school committee will meet in room 302 for the same purpose. The public reception will be held immediately thereafter in the foyer out front. Everybody is welcome. The inaugural exercises are now complete. The Lynn Police and Fire Department Honor Guard will escort the mayor, the Reverend Fathers, and the judges off the stage. City Council and the school committee will follow at this point.